Hi, it's Dr. Paolo Yamin. We will talk about, in these three chapters about benzene and aromatic molecules. This is the first part of the course. So we will start with chapter one, benzene. In these videos, we will give only the essential and details. You must read them in your notes. We will start with a general introduction. So benzene is known since 1825, and the first chemist to propose a structure for benzene was Kekulé. So the formula of benzene is C6H6. Kekulé proposed the structure of benzene. It is not an aliphatic molecule, it is a cyclic molecule containing three conjugated double bonds. So this molecule is not aliphatic, it is cyclic, containing a certain number of pi electron. We called it an aromatic molecule. So you have seen in organic one, aliphatic and cyclic. Here we are going to talk about the aromatic molecule. As you know, the electron pi in a molecule can jump. We call it delocalization of electron. So these two electrons can jump here, forcing these two to jump here and these two to jump here. So we have what we call a resonance structure for benzene, represented by double arrows. So the second resonance structure of benzene is this one, with jumping of the electrons here. So from now on, to simplify the structure of benzene, we will represent benzene like this, with a circle inside it. This circle is 6 pi electron moving all the time around inside this ring or this cloud. So we have a cloud of 6 pi electrons inside a benzene, and benzene, the carbon here, it is hybridized sp2 for benzene. So what are the kinds of reactions that benzene can undergo? Here we have 6 H's on the benzene. I did not draw them first. So we have 6 H's. You know, when we have a double bond, the most important reaction is the addition on the double bond. But if you do addition on double bond of benzene, we will break the ring, the aromaticity. We need very high energy. So benzene does not prefer addition. Why? Because it will break its aromaticity, its ring. So benzene prefer substitution reactions. So substitution reaction, where we can substitute one of the 6 H's by other groups. Okay, the 6 H's of benzene are equivalent, so you can substitute any H with a group A, B, etc. So if you want to do a mono substitutional product, substituting one H, you can choose any H you like and you substitute it by A. So you can place A here, 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 etc. It's the same. So we have one mono substitution product. If I want to do a di substitution with A and B, or A and A, they can be the same substitution or different, you can place AB here on adjacent carbon. So the compound, it is called ortho, with a symbol O and dash. If you have to place A and B like this, separated by one carbon, here B or here, it is the same. It is called meta, with a symbol M. And if you want to place A and B separated by two carbon, we have the para compound P. So we have three disubstituted products for benzene: A, B, this one ortho, this one meta, and this one para. So this was a general introduction on the benzene chapter. So I repeat, benzene is an aromatic molecule containing 6 pi electrons inside it. It has two resonance structure, and benzene prefer substitution rather than addition, because the addition will break the aromaticity. We have one monosubstitution product and three disubstituted product: ortho, meta, and para. Now, what are the reaction of substitution on the benzene cycle? Now we will give only the reaction, and the mechanism will be explained in chapter two. So, two reactions of substitution on the benzene cycle. All the reaction of substitution on the benzene cycle are called SEAR, electrophilic aromatic substitution, and in chapter 2 we'll explain why this name. We can substitute the H of benzene by many groups. The first substitution, we can substitute the H by NO2, so the reaction, it is called nitration. What is this reaction? You take benzene, you add nitric acid, HNO3. This reaction needs an acid as a catalyst. Usually, sometimes we use H2SO4, or you can use other acid. So we will substitute your H by NO2. So you have substituted NO2 here. You will have HO here and H, so plus water. You can write it as a developed or as a molecular, so C6H6 plus HNO3. I will write it only for this example. Other examples, I will write it developed, H plus. You will form C6H5NO2 plus water. So this is the first reaction, nitration. We have another reaction, but we don't see it a lot, which is nitrosation. So instead of placing the group NO2, we are going to place the group NO. It's the same reaction, but instead of using HNO3, which is the nitric acid, we use HNO2, which is the nitrous acid, H plus. So I will have benzene NO plus water. This group is nitro. This group NO, it is the group nitroso. Okay, so these are the first reaction of nitration and nitrosation. Let's move to other reactions. Now, halogenation. I am going to replace the H of benzene by a halogen. So I will take benzene. I will take X2. Usually we add a catalyst of iron like Fe or FeCl3, FeBr3. We can also add AlCl3. Okay, so we will obtain benzene X plus XHHX. Pay attention, this reaction of halogenation is only done with Cl2 and Br2. So we cannot introduce via halogenation the iodo and F fluoro. We will see how to introduce them later. So this was the reaction of halogenation. We move to another reaction. Reaction of Friedel-Crafts. Friedel and Crafts are two chemists. They have done two reactions on benzene. The first one, it is called the Friedel-Crafts alkylation. From now on, I will write Friedel-Crafts because we will see it a lot in this course, FC. So FC alkylation, you will replace the H of the benzene by a group R, which is the alkyl. How? You use an alkyl halide, RCl, with a Lewis acid, like AlCl3. You will obtain R plus HCl. What is a Lewis acid? Zakirkun, Lewis acid, it's an acid having a free orbital capable of receiving a free pair of electrons. The substance that can give a free pair of electrons is a Lewis base. The substance that receives a free pair of electrons is a Lewis acid. So this is the reaction of Friedel-Crafts alkylation. We move now to Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay, FC acylation. Instead of placing the group R alkyl, we will place the group acyl. What is the group acyl? It's R C double bond O. Okay, so I will take the benzene. I will take the RCOCl, not RCl. This is acid or acyl chloride because it comes from the carboxylic acid, RCOH. We also need a Lewis acid, same conditions as before, like AlCl3. I will obtain benzene, COR plus HCl. So this reaction will give a ketone, COR, a ketone. Shiftu ma Dr. Rima, it's RCOR ketone. Here, the R is a benzene, so it is an aromatic ketone, not an aliphatic. So we have seen a lot of reactions on the benzene cycle. We still have one reaction, sulfonation, and I have left it till the end because this is the only reaction which is reversible. Yani I can attach the group on the benzene cycle and I can remove it. How? So you take benzene and you take sulfuric acid, but here it's a reagent. It is not a catalyst like we placed it before on the arrow. So this reaction will give benzene SO3H plus water. How you will move like this, or how you will move like this? It depends on Le Chatelier principle, how to shift the equilibrium to the right or to the left. And I think we have finished the reactions of a benzene cycle. Okay, so here you need diluted H plus or concentrated H plus. So as a summary for this part, we can substitute the H of benzene by NO2 via nitration, NO via nitrosation, ClBr via halogenation, R via Friedel-Crafts alkylation, COR via acylation, and H2SO4 reversible via sulfonation. The product itself, we'll see later, it will undergo another substitution and another substitution, etc. So this was part two in this chapter, the reactions of the benzene without their mechanism. Their mechanism will be studied in chapter two. Now, we will move to see benzene, it is an aromatic molecule. Why it is an aromatic? So we have what we call the rule of aromaticity. Okay, so why we say this molecule is aromatic? Why this molecule is non-aromatic? Sorry. Okay, so a molecule aromatic, it must be flat, resist to the addition reaction, and it will undergo substitution. It goes from 3 to 7 members, then if you can 3 cycle 4 5 etc. But the most important rule, it must contain, so the rule of aromaticity, it must contain inside the cycle 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Zakir control pi electron. Pi electrons are the electrons of the double and triple bonds. What is 4n plus 2 electrons? So the n is a number. It's a whole number, not a fraction. So n, it can be 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So if n equals 0, this bitla a number of electron 2. 2 pi electron. If n is 1, 6 pi electron. If n is 2, 10 pi electron, etc. So you take your molecule, you count the number of pi electron. If it is 2, 6, 10, etc., it is aromatic. If not, it is not aromatic. Okay, let's see some examples. And you will tell me if this, if these molecules are aromatic or non-aromatic. If I take a 5-membered ring like this one, positive charge here, this is a methyl. If I take this one with a radical, if I take this one, sorry, it's a 5-membered ring with a minus. Let's take, for example, this one. If I take this one, if I take this one, I will take also this one, and I will take the benzene. Okay, let's count the number of pi electrons in each structure. The positive charge is a deficit in electrons, so I don't count it. So it is 2, 4. So 4 pi electron. According to Hacker rule, is it aromatic? No, it must contain 6, 10, as we have said, or 2. So it is not aromatic. Here, 2, 4, the radical is 1 electron, 5 pi electron, so it is also not aromatic. The minus is 2 electrons, so these 2 electrons, they can jump by resonance, tac, tac, tac. So it is counted, 2, 4, 6, 6 pi electrons, so it is aromatic. So everything inside the ring, you must count it as pi electron. Here, you will tell me it's 4, but it's not 4. Because on the nitrogen, we have a free pair of electrons. And this pair of electrons can enter inside the cycle. So it is 6 pi electrons, so it is aromatic. Here, the 2 electrons can also enter inside the cycle. So it is 6 pi electrons, so it is aromatic. Let's see here. If you see these double bonds, they cannot reach the cycle. So I cannot count them. So it is 4 pi electrons only, these two. For benzene, it is 6 pi electrons, so it is aromatic. And this compound, you will tell me it's a 12. This is naphthalene that you place inside your closet. But it is not a 12 because we have, if you draw the structure with the double bond, we have double bond in common between the two. So it is 10 pi electrons for naphthalene, so it is aromatic. Okay, so these are some examples of aromatic compound. Now, we still have one part to finish this chapter, how to name benzene when it is substituted. Okay. If we have one substitution on the benzene ring, it is very easy. You name, so naming. If you have one substitution, you name the substitution plus the word benzene. So for example, this is chlorobenzene. This is nitrobenzene. Some compounds have common names that you must memorize. What are the most important ones? Benzene with CH3, it is called toluene. Benzene with OH, it is called phenol. Okay, شو بعد عنا؟ Benzene with NH2, it is called aniline. Benzene with SO3H, it is benzene. Sulfonic acid. And benzene with COH, it is benzoic acid. So these are the most common names. When we have one substitution, you must memorize them. Now, what will happen if we have two substitution? If we have two substitution, always, 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 you must use ortho, meta, or para. Example, if the two substitution are identical, how to name this compound? This is ortho. So ortho dichlorobenzene. If the two substitution are different, we name them in alphabetic order, but we always use ortho, meta, para. So this is meta, bromo in alphabetic order, nitrobenzene. Now, if one of the of them gives a common name that we have seen before, بس عنا هالكيس ما حنشوف two give common names. So in this case, we name the compound function of this one, which is the common name phenol. So para chloro phenol. Okay, if the compounds contain more than two groups, 3, 4, etc., we start using numbers and we use the lowest combination of number, as you can see in your notes. And in case you have one group giving a common name, for example, let's take this one. This is common name, so it is one. Then you choose the lowest combination of number. So it is in alphabetic order, 3-bromo-2-chloro-toluene. Okay, so this is how to name, and you can read details in your notes concerning the naming. Now, you have a last part, polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbon. You are not responsible for this part, but I will tell you very brief thing. What does it mean, polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbon? Instead of having one ring like benzene, you will have two rings together like naphthalene, or three rings together like the molecule anthracene. You are only responsible on how to draw their resonance. How to draw resonance? Let's take the naphthalene. يعني فيني أنا أجي لكم ارسموا لي resonance structure of naphthalene. What do you do? Look here. You place the double bond in the middle. You turn the double bond in the first cycle. You draw it. So the second cycle is intact, and here it is 1, 2, 3. Or you move the first cycle and you let the second cycle intact. 1, 2, 3. So I will have the first cycle intact, and this cycle I will have this one here, this one here, this one. If you have a third cycle, look what will happen. The double bond, we reach the second, you will turn it in the third. If you have a 4, a 4. Okay? So very easy for polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbon to draw resonance. You place the double bond in the middle of the first cycle. You turn it in the first. You turn it in the second. You turn it in the third, etc. And like this, we have finished our first chapter.